So let's come back. Now we have done the physical properties, that is your solubility, boiling point. I've done certain questions which are more frequently asked. Well, let us come back to the main concept, that is your chemical properties. From now, we'll be doing so many reasoning questions, so it's easy for you to solve it in the exam. Along with that, I'll also be doing certain reasoning questions based on your chemical reactions also. Right. So when I have to study about chemical properties, the first important chemical property is basic nature of amines. So, in your chemical properties, there are certain reactions which are common to all the amines and certain which are specific to primary amines, secondary and tertiary. So, now I am going to teach you which are common to all types of amines, that is your primary, secondary and tertiary. So, basic nature, when I have to speak, how is this asked in the exam? They may either directly ask you, explain the basic nature of amines, or they may ask you in this way, what is that question? Is water less basic than amines, or either way, are amines more basic than water, or it's the same question, right? Amines more basic than water, why? If yes, why? Let us reason the question. Now, most important thing, whenever a basic nature or basic strength is explained, or acidic strength is explained, we explain in terms of two important things. What are those? We are going to use for, suppose let us say acidic strength. I have to explain acidic strength of a particular acid, then I use a term Ka, acid ionization constant. Now, what are we doing? We are going to explain about basic strength. So, basic strength is explained by base ionization constant. So, let us write this. This is called base ionization constant. Done. Let's start. Now, I have to prove whether it is basic or not. First important thing, remember in your mind, all amines, I am writing in caps, all amines are more basic than water. First, if you understand, then basic, then water. If you understand this, everything is easy. Basic, then water. So, let me put this in a box. Why are they basic? Because suppose if I take primary amine is one alkyl group and two hydrogens. Secondary amine is two alkyl groups and one hydrogen. Tertiary is three alkyl groups and one. So let us name primary, secondary and tertiary. Suppose if I am trying to dissolve this in water. So water, HOH. I am this also trying to dissolve in water. Now observe. What is happening? Your amine, when you are trying to dissolve in water, first amine tries to form two important compounds. One is this one. Just see, what am I doing? I am trying to break the bond here in hydrogen, between hydrogen and oxygen. And what products do I get? I get an equilibrium product. What is that? Just observe. RNH3+ OH-. First one. Second case, R2NH2+ OH-. Third case in tertiary, RNH++OH-. Now what is happening? Your amines, now I said they're more basic. What are they doing? These amines are trying to, first of all, important thing, these amines are releasing OH- when dissolved in water. That means what are they trying to do? They are going to take out that proton from water, and they are releasing that OH minus. Aren't they stronger than water? Simple, isn't it? Amine is trying to break the bond, pick up that hydrogen and finally release out that OH minus from water. That is the reason they are more basic than water. So what can we say? Amines release OH minus when dissolved in water. So that's the reason they are more basic in nature. So remember this concept, release of OH minus ion. So when I have to write that particular thing, KB for this is equal to concentration of the products RNH3+ OH- divided by your RNH2 for the first one. For the second one, KB is equal to concentration of RNH2+ into OH- divided by the product R2NH for tertiary, KB is equal to R3NH plus OH minus divided by your product R3N. Now, simple. What did I say just now? Because they are removing that or releasing that OH minus in water molecule, they are more stronger than water, isn't it? I mean, I have written three important values. Those are base ionization constant for primary amine, base ionization constant for tertiary amine, secondary amine, and base ionization for tertiary amine. So where am I going to use this value? Basically, we are going to relate or take these values and just see. Everything has a different value. When you try to solve, take this concentration, take this and take this, solve this particular formula, you get certain values. Now we are going to see a new concept called PKB. PKB is equal to negative logarithm of KB. What is this PKB value? That means when I am trying to get this value from here, I'm going to take negative value of this, then I'm going to get PKB. Simple, okay? Yes, so we get this experimental value from here, take negative log of that value, I get PKB. What is the concept? Smaller, again I'm writing in caps, smaller the PKB, stronger is the base. Remember this. If you understand this concept, it's easy. PKB value should be smaller. That means KB value should be larger, isn't it? So PKB, if the value is very small in the question which I'll be dealing, if you have the PKB value very less, that means it is the strongest base. Yes, but opposite, the other way, KB should be higher. So PKB should be lower, KB should be higher, then it is basic in nature. So this is how we are going to explain. So I think I don't, okay, we'll write. Why is amines? Because amines release or produce OH minus when dissolved in water. Hence, are more basic than water. Okay, this is how you're going to write or explain this concept.